and then my steering wheel. I've got my buttons for the gear change. So that's drive, neutral and reverse. Battery operated. It's all contained inside the cover for the centre of the wheel. So it's got a little transmitter and a battery unit in there. A little 3D printed holder for the buttons. Fitted the razor block in here to give me some more space to fit my remote gear change in. Got my receiver and the wiring in there connects up to the existing wiring harness and to the existing switches. But that extra 30mm gives me a lot more volume in there to get all the gubbins inside. See, down the side here we have the normal buttons for drive, neutral and reverse. They still work, so you can operate it using the steering wheel buttons, or you can use the buttons down here. So if the battery runs flat in the remotes, you can still use these buttons to control it. As you can see, this is very awkward, having to poke round about the side of the seat to get to the buttons when you come up to traffic lights or whatever to change gears, get reverse or neutral. It's even worse if you've got a coat on, it covers this and you can't get it. Same at night, you've got to peer down the side. Well, these buttons are illuminated, but a lot easier just to use the buttons on the steering wheel. Right, we'll go for a little drive. As normal when you start up, just turn the ignition on.
Below dash cam active.
Thank you. Then depress the brake pedal and turn the ignition fuel on, and now we're in neutral. So we can use the buttons down the side here and go for drive, neutral, reverse. Neutral, similarly, drive, neutral, reverse. Neutral, drive. So, let's go. So if you come to a halt, you can select neutral. Don't see it. When you press the button without the brake applied, you get a little warning to tell you you haven't got the brake on. But put the brake on, you get drive. Some cars coming, let them get past. So it's a lot easier just to select neutral here rather than having to poke down the side of the seat looking for the buttons. Forward and see what we're doing. Let all clear. So these are the components you need to make your remote gear change to fit on the steering wheel. We have up there is a little 4-channel transmitter. Connect up to 3 buttons and a little aerial, and power it using 2 lithium coin cells in this little battery holder. and put it in a 3D printed housing like that. There's all assembled. These just stick inside the steering wheel cover with some double-sided tape. Same with this, double-sided tape, and it slots on the side of the steering wheel. That's my battery case there with two little lithium coin cells in. A little transmitter, four channel transmitter. And then I've got my 3D printed holder with three buttons. So I've got drive, neutral, reverse. This is the receiver that goes in the box beside the seat where the existing buttons are for the selectors. So that's your receiver. You put a little aerial on that as well. This runs with 3.3 volts voltage, whereas the car is 12 volts. So we're using a little 3.3 volt regulator that steps down the voltage to power this unit. Then the output from this goes to these three very small relays, again 3.3 volt relays, and then these in turn go out back to the switches on the switch panel. On the switch panel there's a green and a brown connector, green and brown connector that come out the existing loom. What you do is you plug them into these adapters. So down in there are little six pins in there that plug into these connectors, equivalent ones of these that are on the existing loom. And then what we're doing, we're splicing in and taking switch signals back to the relay board that has these relays on. This is a board that I made. It's got the three relays on. So the brown one controls the reverse button on the switch panel, and the green one controls the drive in neutral, and it also has the 12 volt power on it as well. Well, certainly I take the 12 volt power from this one via that little regulator, which I've housed in this box, which then powers the receiver, which again I've attached a bit of prototype board, this board here. It's easier for me to get all the connections on, solder them on, and then take them to another piece of this strip board with the relays on. This is all a bit of a lash up. I was going to put them all in nice little boxes, but I didn't have quite enough room in the seat box area. When you try to put the switch panel on top, it was hitting on various pieces because there wasn't quite enough room. I need to miniaturise the boxes and get that in a better position. So anyway, I had to source these connectors that plug into the switch panel. These were fairly difficult to find and had to buy quite a few of them. They come as a two-part that you load up and then press together once you've loaded all the terminals. You get the pins that go in, you crimp these on using the crimp wires, crimp them to bits of wire, put them in, close it up, and you end up with something like that plugs in. Yes, I need to miniaturise this a bit more so I can get everything in. I had these just taped up and pushed into the bottom of the box, and I had just enough room to get all the wiring in, but again, that can all be rationalised. The switches, these ones are
are from eBay. I think I got a bag of 10 of them for peanuts. And the transmitter and receiver, I think, was like £10 for three. The relay board was, again, a couple of pounds. Other than that, just need to 3D print a few parts. I 3D printed these housings that accepts these connectors. These connectors are keyed. The green one has a key on that edge there, and the brown one has a key higher up on that edge. And similarly, I just printed the housings with the notch there or the notch there, depending on which one I was using. Tricky part is soldering it all together and checking all your wiring. It can get a bit confusing when you're looking at connectors on end on and the mirror images of them on boards and connectors. It does seem to work okay. These little relays work fine. There's no real expensive parts in there at all.
Got my receiver and the wiring in there. Connects up to the existing wiring harness and to the existing switches. But that extra 30mm gives me a lot more volume in there to get all the gubbins inside. See, down the side here we have the normal buttons for drive, neutral and reverse. They still work, so you can operate it using the steering wheel buttons, or you can use the buttons down here. So if the battery runs flat in the remotes, you can still use these buttons to control it. As you can see, this is very awkward, having to poke around about the side of the seat to get to the buttons when you come up to traffic lights or whatever to change gears, get reverse or neutral. It's even worse if you've got a coat on, it covers this and you can't get it. Same at night, you've got to peer down the side. Well, these buttons are illuminated, but a lot easier just to use the buttons on the steering wheel.